In this tutorial video, we're going to talk about how to work with color in Adobe Animate CC. In a previous tutorial video, we've learned that Animate CC creates objects with strokes and fills. If you've worked with Adobe Illustrator before, you're probably already familiar with this concept. So a fill is the internal, inside color of a shape. So right now, the fill of all of these shapes is this kind of light bluish green. The outside color, this black line, is what we call the stroke. So any of the outlines or strokes on an object are a separate thing that you can fill with color. Now, if we come over here to the Properties panel, we can change our stroke here. So I can go ahead and change this to a deep red. I can even make it thicker. And then I can come in here and change the fill. So if I wanted my fill to maybe be this golden yellow, and then let's say I wanted to change a couple of these other circles. Well, I can do it one of two ways. If I want to change the stroke on a circle, I can come over here to this little paint bucket looking tool with this additional square on it. So even though it looks like a paint bucket, it's actually called the ink bottle tool. And the ink bottle tool will change your stroke. So if I click on that, it'll look at whatever the stroke color is of the selected object on the stage. And then you can click on any other object and change that stroke color. Notice that it also increased the thickness of the stroke because we increased the thickness of this stroke. So it really is just painting the stroke's appearance on new objects. If we wanted to change the fill, we would need to use the paint bucket tool. The paint bucket tool again is going to look at the fill that is created from the object that's selected on the stage, and it'll start painting that fill color in different objects. So working with strokes and fills are the most basic form of working with color in Adobe Animate CC. However, there is also the color panel, the swatches panel, and the gradient tool that you can work with. So let's take a look at that. I'm going to undo all these different color changes that we've made so we can kind of start with this original look. Okay, so I'll switch back to my selection tool. And up here in the color panel, which if you can't see, you can go up to the window menu and choose color. Same thing with the swatches panel. If you have both of them open, it's going to be easier when you're working with color. So right now, what this is going to do is it's choosing what my stroke color is and my fill color. Because my fill color is selected, when I go and change the color here, it's going to change the fill color. If I click the stroke and change the color this way, I can change the stroke color. So whichever button is pressed here is the one that it's going to change. In addition, when you're changing colors, you can choose through hue. So that's changing just by color. Saturation, so how saturated your color actually is. And then you can also choose for brightness. So if you know you want this shade of pink, but you want it to be a dark pink, or you want it to be a really light pink, then you can absolutely work that way. You can also work with RGB values, and you can work with alpha channel. So alpha is the transparency. If I switch to my fill right here, and let's say I change my fill to this really deep dark blue, and I move my object over here and arrange it so it's sitting on top. If I change my alpha to a certain percentage, notice that I can see through that deep blue fill, but I can't see through the stroke. If I click on the stroke, I can adjust the alpha this way and keep trying to adjust. Oh, it's not working because I didn't have it selected. So anyway, we can go ahead and do that. And now you should be able to see the other objects through the stroke and the fill because we messed with the alpha. So let's go ahead and grab this object again just to move it up here. And we'll bring that back to 100% so we can really see what we're doing here. You can also change the alpha here. All right, so a couple other buttons. This will switch the stroke and the fill. So if you want to switch between those, and I'll go ahead and make a thicker stroke so we can really see what's happening here. So we'll switch the stroke and the fill. We can also go back to the default of black and white and switch to black and white. And then if I want to make sure my fill is no color, I can choose no color. And that looks better if we go back to that purple and blue. So if I click no color, it's going to remove the fill. If I click no color again, it's going to remove the stroke. So I'll go ahead and undo that, but those are those three little buttons right there. And again, you can pick a custom color here to work with. And if you pick a custom color here, this is the hexadecimal code. So if you're working with specific colors, let's say for a branded project, then you can definitely enter the hexadecimal colors in here. In addition, you can double click inside each of these and come up with a swatches panel, which you can see down here. And these are helpfully organized with different shades of gray, the primary colors, and then different shades of all the different hues. They also have a couple of gradients here, which we'll talk about in a second. If you want to choose no color for the fill or whatever one you chose, you can click no color here, change the alpha, and this is also where you can type in the hexadecimal. You can come to this bigger color picker that we're used to with like Illustrator and Photoshop if you'd rather work with this type of interface. So when you create colors that you really like, so let's say I'm going to turn this to a deep purple, and this one will do kind of that outside teal color. When you work with colors that you really like, you can add to swatches, and it's going to add those swatches into the swatches panel. The great thing about adding those swatches into the swatches panel is later on, if I want to use those same colors, they're really easy to grab, and I don't have to look for the hexadecimal or the RGB values or any of this kind of information. They're just right there and easily clickable. So let's go ahead and start talking about bitmap fills and gradients. We'll start with a bitmap fill first. If we choose a bitmap fill just basically means you're going to use a bitmap, an image, or a pixel graphic to fill either the stroke or the fill color of an object. So if I choose bitmap fill, I can go and look for a picture. So let's see what picture would look good for this. We'll choose this picture, this Orion Nebula picture, and click open. And notice that because the fill icon was chosen, then it's going to fill that with the bitmap image. I'll go ahead and undo. And if I select multiple objects, I can also choose bitmap. And it's going to put that bitmap object into all of those different objects. And last but not least, if I click on this and change this to the stroke color and choose bitmap fill, then I can have that Orion Nebula in the stroke instead of the fill color. Okay, so let's go ahead and undo that. And let's start talking about a gradient. I'll go ahead and remove this stroke just so we can have a clean circle to work with. When you add a gradient, you can either choose from linear or radial. Unlike Illustrator and Photoshop, we only have two gradient options. So I'll go ahead and choose radial because I want to make this look like a ball. Now, when you usually choose a gradient, it'll give you black and white for your two color options here. I've already messed with this gradient, so that's why it has this kind of garish green and deep blue. And it doesn't matter what color is picked here because you can always add or take away or change things. So if I double click in here and let's say I wanted to make a blue ball, I can have light blue here and leave this dark blue. And if I wanted to, I could throw in another color here by just clicking, and then I can double click each of these color stops and add different colors into this object. So if I don't like those colors, which I don't because they're hideous, I can drag those off. And I think I added too many, so they're like stacked on top of each other. So there we go. I just wanted this plain dark blue to light blue. Now, if I like this radial gradient and I'm going to use it often, then I can click to add to swatches and it'll add that radial gradient swatch. So that's really handy if later on I want to come in here and I want to choose this as my particular fill color. In addition, if I click the stroke color and click that, it's going to give me a radial gradient, but you can't really see it with this particular stroke. It works better when you have a linear gradient. So with this radial gradient, even though we can switch these color stops and move them closer together or further apart or whatever it may be, you can also edit this color by going to this tool here. It's called the Gradient Transform tool, and usually it's hidden under the Free Transform tool, so make sure you look for it. It's the third button down. So if we click the Gradient Transform tool, you can see that the tool is going to show up on this gradient. And you can click the center part of that gradient and move it around so you can change the light source. You can make it squashed or wider. So I kind of like that. And then I can also resize it. And then I can rotate it however I see fit. So that gives me a much better looking ball that I can maybe bounce around. Maybe it's a planet, whatever it may be. So you can manipulate gradients, maybe not to the extent that you can do it with something like Illustrator and the gradient mesh tool, but you can manipulate some of the gradients in Animate CC to get some great color. So that's the basics of working with color in Adobe Animate CC. We've covered the stroke and the fill, the ink bottle for strokes, the paint bucket for fill, and then how to switch between the stroke and the fill, add a bitmap fill, and work with gradients and the gradient tool. So make sure you practice working with color, and for sure, add your colors to the swatches so you can work smarter, not harder.